Hello students, welcome back to our science class. So now we are in second term, first lesson. So in the previous video we have learnt about food, right? The first lesson, food. So we have learnt about raw food and cooked food. We have learnt about raw food and cooked food. Now we are going to revise this raw food and cooked food. Okay, so what is raw food? Food that we eat directly without cooking is called raw food. Okay, all those food which we eat directly without cooking are known as raw food. For example, fruits, vegetables, tubers and nuts, right? Okay, what is raw food? Food that we eat directly without cooking is known as raw food. And what is cooked food? What is cooked food? Food which we cook and eat are known as cooked food. We cannot eat this type of food raw. Okay, we are cooking and eating those foods are known as cooked food. We cannot eat all the food items in raw form. Food that needs to be processed using heat before it can be eaten is known as cooked food. Okay, so why we need to cook food? We need to cook food because cooked food is digested easily. Cooking softens the food materials. If we cook the food, all the germs will be killed. And cooking adds taste and flavor to food. Okay. So, we have written some raw foods and cooked food here. So, fruits, some vegetables, carrots and cucumber. Cooked food, rice, tubers, egg, meat and fish. Okay, so this we learnt in the previous class. Difference between raw food and the cooked food. What is raw food? Food that can be eaten directly without cooking is known as raw food. And what is cooked food? Food that needs to be processed using heat before it can be consumed are known as cooked food. Okay, raw food example, fruits, vegetables, nuts. And cooked food examples, all those rice and some boiled vegetables, boiled eggs are known as cooked foods. Okay. And the second room letter, the first lesson, second room letter, we are going to learn about cooking methods. Okay. So, what is the meaning of cooking methods? So, we are going to learn the method of cooking. So, all the food are not cooked in the same method. All the foods are cooked in different method. Right? So now we are going to learn about cooking methods. Okay, some of the commonly used cooking methods are given below. So what are the methods of cooking? Boiling, steaming, pressure cooking, roasting and frying. Okay, boiling, steaming, pressure cooking, roasting and frying. So, what are the methods of cooking? Boiling, steaming, pressure cooking, roasting and frying. So, what is the meaning of boiling? For example, we can take rice and egg. It is a method of cooking by immersing it in a boiling water. Okay. So, boiling, it is a method of cooking. We are going to immerse the food into a boiling water or known as boiling method. Okay, so that the food becomes very soft. For example, rice and egg. Okay, so how we will prepare rice? We will prepare rice by boiling method. How we will prepare egg? We will prepare egg by boiling method. Okay, the next method is steaming. The second method we are going to learn is steaming. Okay. So, it is a method of cooking. It is a method of cooking food in steam by immersing the vessel in a container with boiling water. For example, idli and idiyappam. So, how we will prepare idli? We will immerse the vessel in a container, right? We will add the flour, idli flour, and we will immerse the vessel into a container and we will boil the water, right? So, these methods are known as steaming. The steam which comes from the heat will prepare the food. Okay, so the example is idli and idiyappam. Okay, so boiling, steaming. The third method, pressure cooking. Okay, it is a method of cooking food in a pressure cooker. So how many of you have seen pressure cooker? Yes. So the food which we prepare by using a pressure cooker are known as pressure cooking. It is a method of cooking food in a pressure cooker. Okay, for example, rice and dal. For example, rice and dal. So rice and dal will cook by pressure cooking method. Okay, the next one, roasting. So what are the methods? Boiling, steaming, pressure cooking, roasting and frying. Okay, so roasting, it is a method of cooking food by heating on a tawa or frying pan without covering it. Okay, so you need to understand the difference between roasting and frying. Okay, both are different methods. Roasting means it is a method of cooking food by heating on a tawa without covering it. Okay, for example, groundnuts and cashew nuts. See in this picture. So in this picture, we can able to see the groundnut which they are preparing in roasting method. Okay, without covering it, they are preparing. So this method is known as roasting method. Example, groundnuts and cashew nuts. Okay, next, frying. It is a method of cooking food in hot oil. For example, chips and puri. So how we will prepare puri? We prepare puri by using a hot oil, right? So this method are known as frying. Okay, so you need to understand the difference between roasting and frying. Roasting means it is a method of cooking food by heating on a tawa or frying pan without covering it. Okay, whereas frying means it is a method of cooking food in hot oil. Okay, so the examples for roasting is groundnuts and for frying is puri. Okay, here we have some cooking methods given in a flow chart. Okay, so what are the cooking methods? Moist heat, dry heat and other methods. So we will use moist heat method, dry heat method and other methods to cook. Okay, so boiling, steaming and pressure cooking, it comes under moist heat. Okay, what is the meaning of moist heat? Moist heat means it won't be any dry. Okay, it will be with moisture. Okay, whereas dry heat means roasting, baking and frying. Very dry. Okay, then other methods, microwave cooking and solar cooking. Okay, so three types of cooking methods, moist heat, dry heat and other methods. In moist heat, we have boiling, steaming, pressure cooking. And in dry heat, we have roasting, baking, frying. And in other methods, we have microwave cooking and solar cooking. So in this microwave cooking, we have learnt in the previous term itself. What is the meaning of solar cooking? Solar cooking means we are using the solar current for cooking. Okay. So the next, cooking habits. So they have given some habits to be followed. Wash your hands with soap before cooking. This is very important point. Wash your hands with soap before cooking to avoid germs. Okay. The second point, wash vegetables and fruits before cutting. We need to wash the vegetables and fruits before cutting and consuming it. Okay. Third point, wash cooking vessels and knives. Okay, we have to wash the cooking vessels and also the knives which we use to cut. Next point, don't cook food for a long time because it destroys the nutrients present in the food. We should not cook the food for so long time. Okay, so we have to cook for a little time because if we cook for a long time, it will destroy the nutrients present in the food. The next point, don't use the same oil for cooking food many times. Okay, so in hotels and all, they will use the same oil continuously for cooking. So we need to avoid the hotel foods. Okay, don't use the same oil for cooking food many times. Okay, the last point, using the food items after their expiry date is not good for health. So when we purchase some food items, what we have to do? We have to check the expiry date. It is very important. We should not use the food items after their expiry date. It is not good for our health. Okay, so we need to follow all this method for the good habit while cooking. Okay, next, this you have to do. Okay, tabulate the given food items according to their cooking methods. So they have given some food items like rice, puri, muruk, popcorn, idli, milk, fish, puttu, dal, idiyappam and groundnut. You are going to separate all these food items in this methods. What are the methods they have given? Boiling, steaming, roasting and frying. So for example, first we take rice. Okay, rice is which method? Yes, boiling method. Okay, rice is boiling method. So write rice in the boiling. Next, puri. So puri comes under? Yes, frying method. So write puri in frying method. Muruk is also frying. Popcorn comes under roasting method. Okay, then idli comes under steaming. Milk comes under boiling. Fish comes under boiling. Puttu comes under steaming. Idiyappam, it also comes under steaming. Groundnut, it comes under roasting. Okay, so you copy this in your book using pencil. Okay, thank you, students.